Hey everyone, thanks for checking out another Ad Math video. In this week's video, we're gonna take a look at market growth. A critical task in planning your marketing is to identify growth opportunities. These usually come in the form of financial performance and market share, which we discussed in a previous video. Your market growth has a direct implication on your competitive position. The growth of your product or service signals market acceptance and a potential competitive advantage. This is especially true if your growth outpaces that of your competition. In fact, an aspect of market growth that you should be really focused on is whether your growth is faster, slower, or on pace with the market as a whole, since the answer could have an impact on your marketing plan, channels you use, or even your audience. The process to determine market growth is straightforward, but like market share, it's a key part of the foundation for many other metrics that we'll touch upon in the Ad Math video series. So let's take a look at how it works. Basically, you need to know or understand two numbers. One is your total revenue or units sold for a given period last year or last period, and then the increase in the current period over last period. So again, you need to know a total number for how many you sold either last quarter, last year, and then the increase above that number for this current period. So let's assume last year you did $400 million worth of revenue, and then this year you've done $500 million. So that's $100 million on top, or an increase on the $400 million. So to figure out your growth rate, you do the math, and it's 0.25 or a 25% growth rate. So if you look at that in terms of units sold, same principle applies. Let's say that last year you released a new product towards the end of the year, and you sold 850,000 of those things. And then this year, on top of the 850, you sold an additional 4,500,000 things. You do the math on that, and it's 5.29 or 529% market growth. Once you determine your market growth number, use the information you have from industry trades and your competitive research to identify and compare against your competitors' growth. Now, just like they say with stocks, past performance does not indicate future results. However, your market number should provide you with a good indication of how things are going so that you can plan and adjust your marketing approach accordingly. We hope this video helped. If so, give us a huge thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we'll release a new Ad Math video each Wednesday. And finally, if you have a marketing metric you'd like us to break down in an upcoming video, let us know by adding it in the comments.